I think when you look at it from a landlord perspective, you have to look at the traditional grocery anchored center as the best or the most popular asset type among most institutional investors in high growth demographic areas. But other areas are also very popular. The retail investors love net lease assets, and there is tremendous interest in Class A malls. The problem with Class A malls is they never trade. Maybe you can get a JV interest in them. I think some of the other assets that are the second tier power center, second tier malls, people are going to have to look at new formats. And that also creates a great opportunity. So in my community where I live in Baltimore, there are two great properties in my market, both of whom were former JCPenney Sears anchored assets, now are two of the best assets in the market because they brought in a great grocer like a Wegmans and other restaurants and other things increasing foot traffic. That means, goes right back to my central point, that good rooftops means good retail, even if it needs to change.
Lots of patience. Deals that are taking longer to get done, going through city approvals, as well as going through tenant approval process, as well as ownership's ability to make sure they have enough capital to get the deal done, has lengthened the time it takes to get a deal done.
To get a retail deal done today takes having well-located properties, properties that are in the flow of traffic, where their location unquestionably will hold up over time. And then it also takes ownership that isn't looking for every last bit of leverage, that have been through the ups and downs and the cyclicalities of the market, and understand that they're best served in the long run by moderating the leverage that they put on a property, and then also being innovative and creative about the use of the property.
A lot of patience and education. The key is, if you're leasing a property, you cannot rely upon the tenant's broker or the landlord, the real estate rep, to know more than you do about the property. They're doing things on a national basis. You have to educate them as to why your property works and give them enough information that when they go to real estate committee, their job is done and your property sits on top.